Ms. Alva, the Raj Nivas, where you were, of course, governor in the past, is now the hotbed of political activity. Ashok Gehlot, chief minister, saying governor must allow him to convene an assembly session. What is your view? Does the governor have a discretion to decide whether an assembly session can be called or not?
Rajdeep, the most important thing is that majority of a government is to be tested on the floor of the assembly, not in Raj Bhavans. And the governor has to be neutral. He is no longer a member of any party. If the chief minister feels that he would like to prove his majority on the floor of the house and is requesting a session of the assembly, what is the problem for the governor to call the assembly and sort out the issue?
The problem, Ms. Alva, according to Governor Kalraj Mishra, is A, there is no emergency that requires such a session to be called. Ashok Gehlot at no stage has suggested that his majority has been lost, so there is no immediate necessity to prove it on the floor of the House. And these are COVID times. In COVID times, the governor is saying there is no urgency to call the session.
Right. I concede that. If that is so, then the only thing is to await the decision of the courts on Monday. But I am one who believes that these issues should not be settled in the courtroom and by judges. There is the anti-defection law, there is the constitutional provisions which give a certain direction, if I may say so, to sort out these issues. But Rajdeep, there's something beyond that that I wish to say this evening. Mr. Pilot has very clearly said, I am not leaving the party. He has said, I have no intention to pull down the government. He has said, I'm not going to the BJP. Now, once these statements have been made, I think it becomes an internal party issue in which neither the governor nor the courts have a role to play. I believe, and I'm saying this very honestly, this is an issue which must be sorted out within the party by the Congress president. If she calls the two of them to a cup of tea at 10 Janpath, makes them sit before her face to face and serves them a cup of tea, it will end up as a storm in a teacup. I think that there is no crisis, I agree, because nobody is leaving the party, nobody wants to leave the party. Then where was the need?
No, nobody wa- ma'am.
Pardon?
Ma'am, I take your point. Nobody wants. Sachin Pilot officially says he's not leaving
exactly.
The party. But he and 18 MLAs are not in Jaipur. They are in a hotel in Manesar. Some of them are in Delhi. They are not attending a Congress legislature party meeting. This has carried on for 2 weeks. Ashok Gehlot's supporters are in Fairmont Hotel. Sachin Pilot's supporters are in a hotel in Manesar. How long can this continue? And you said you want the two leaders to be brought to 10 Janpath and over a cup of tea, Sonia Gandhi to sort it out. Sonia Gandhi has not said a word. The fact is, doesn't this show the failure of the high command to enforce an element of discipline?
I don't know. You know, Rajdeep, I've been general secretary of the party for many years. I've handled 15 states during my period. Anytime there was a dispute, an internal dispute in the party, there are ego clashes, there are different issues. It is for people sitting in Delhi to intervene and sort them out. None of us want Sachin Pilot to leave the party and go. He is one of our brightest young leaders. In fact, all these young people were supposed to be the team that Rahul was creating, the second rung of leadership. What has happened? Why has all this collapsed? I don't understand. In fact, as one...
That's exactly what I want to know. Why has this happened? What has happened? 1 year after your big defeat in the Lok Sabha election, there seems no introspection in your party. You're losing state after state. Your government has gone in Madhya Pradesh. Now it's in danger in Rajasthan. And there seems no intervention of the kind that you're talking about to get the two sides together. What does that show?
I'm as concerned as you are. I'm telling you that there is no reason why the High Command cannot put these two people together. After all, Sachin has worked for 5 or 6 years as party president to build this party, to defeat the BJP. Why will he want to now go and join hands with the BJP? We have to accommodate.
Because he wants to be chief minister. Because he wants to be chief minister.
And
only one person can be chief minister. Maybe Mr. Pilot wants to take BJP support and become chief minister.
No, there are many alternatives that can be worked out. The chief minister's post is not the only thing in life. Pilot has to understand that. But Rajdeep, all that apart, these young leaders in every state are impatient. They are looking for ways by which they should be involved in decision making, that the High Command should find a way of accommodating him. This is something which I agree with you, we have failed to do. I think this is a tragedy. And I would still appeal to the party High Command to put them together and get this out of the courts and Rajbhavans and the streets.
Ma'am, the question though is, and there are many observers now suggesting this, that maybe the Congress needs to look beyond the Gandhi-Nehru family. Maybe you need a new leadership. Maybe you need more churning. Maybe you need a more active CWC, which starts taking decisions more aggressively, and you need elections to the CWC. Do you agree in the first instance that maybe the Congress needs to look beyond the Gandhi-Nehru family?
I feel it's time to recast the working committee totally. I said the other day in an interview when I was asked, the average age of our population, look at it, 50% below the age of 30 or 25. And look at the working committee. The average age must be about 70 or above. Why aren't young people brought into the working committee to make it more representative of the reality outside? That's what we expected from Rahul Gandhi. I had hoped and we had waited for him to create a team of his own with all these bright young people who came into the party to be with him, to help him. They have to create a second level of leadership. Rajdeep, when I came into the Rajya Sabha, I was 31. Indira ji picked up Ambika Soni, me, there was Priyaranjan Das Gupta from Bengal. Priyaranjan Das Munshi, I'm sorry. There was Mamata Banerjee. There were young people from all over the country whom she handpicked, created a second level of leadership. So did Rajiv ji. Rajiv ji's cabinet, we were all first-time ministers. He picked us up, handpicked us.
But why? But maybe, ma'am, Rahul Gandhi has failed because, you know, he attempted to do so and has failed. And now he's no longer Congress president. Do you want him to come back or do you believe it's time for someone else to take a shot at trying to, in a way, rejig this party? Why not someone else outside the Gandhi-Nehru family?
They have all repeatedly said, let someone come and take the responsibility. Not one person will stand up and say, I am prepared to step in. I am prepared to help. I am prepared to come. Everybody just sits behind closed doors and takes decisions. I think the time has come to recast the working committee, bring in new faces, young faces, and for Rahul to decide that he will lead.
No, so are you saying that Rahul Gandhi has to return as Congress president, or does the Congress need a new face? As the Congress president, Rahul Gandhi lost the election to Narendra Modi in 2019, lost it in 2014. Maybe it's time for a new face.
But Rajdeep, also remember that during his time, we won 5 state governments and we were in coalition in 2. The BJP didn't win a single state. They went except in Goa where they manipulated, Manipur where they manipulated, except for Haryana, Himachal Pradesh and UP. Where else have they formed a government? So, tell me. You talk so much about the BJP's sweep. Where have they swept? In the south, they don't have two seats, the whole of the south. Where do they have seats? Do they have...
Ma'am, the fact is today in all the major states,
so don't wipe out the Congress. The Congress has its roots.
I'm not wiping, ma'am. The fact is the Congress has hit its lowest level ever in the Lok Sabha. The fact is in major states the Congress has been a declining force, and then you are losing governments at the moment to the BJP. We can you can accuse them of toppling your government. That's fair enough. That's your charge. But my question to you, therefore, is this. Do you believe that the time has come, as you said, rejig the CWC, but also Rahul Gandhi then has to decide. You can't be in politics and out of it. Then you've got to be 24/7. If you have to be a Congress president, you've got to be 24/7. At the moment, Sonia Gandhi is only an interim president. You seem to have some kind of a vacuum at the top.
Well, I'm not commenting on that, but I do think the time has come for a generation shift in the states, in the working committee, and in the leadership of the party. We have all worked. I worked 50 years in the party. I know I have the experience, but I'm not saying that people like me should continue indefinitely. I started at the age of 27. We have all played our role. We have done what we could do. Today, I think the new generation has to take over, has to bring in a new dynamism, a new vision. This is what the young voter is looking for today.
Hello, everyone. This is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.